Could you do me a favor, please? Could you sit down and cry with me for, let's say, 2.5 days? My cover is too small. Hi there, this is Luise Heinzel. Welcome to my channel, Junk Journal Art, and welcome to an episode of Luise Heinzel's disaster projects. I don't know. Look at this. I've made this fabric cover here. It's a soft cover, obviously, and I've sewn in my, I think, 14 signatures into this thingy here. I wanted to make a hidden spine to this journal, and when I lay this down here and line it up here and I flip this over, I realized that this is too small. In the meantime, I have figured out why, but I'm so sad and I'm so disappointed about myself. You can't believe that. This journal has a really unusual size. I wanted to make something that's like a giant traveler's notebook. So as you can see, this is really slim and high at the same time. And I've never done this format before. And I don't know what was in my head when I measured this, but as you can see, it will not fit around here. Even if I, make it like this and look here, it's obviously too short as well. I don't know if this thing is really a rectangle. Perhaps I have not don't have 90 degree here or whatever. I don't know, but I have to find a solution for this thing, and I would be really happy if you join me finding this solution. I have in the meantime tried out what will happen when I when I turn this around and use this as the inside, because, I mean, I came to this idea because this is an upholstery fabric, and this is really raised. This, I think it's called pile of the fabric, is really high. And when I take it like this and put it here to the correct place and do it like this, it's a little bit better, but it's still too short. So I think if I would make it like this, I would be able to handle it and the pages would only peek out a tiny little bit. But I don't like this for the outside. I've spent so many hours to to this fabric, to dye that and to make it look like this. I've sewn here, as you can see, and that was also not so easy to sew through the fabric and this upholstery thing. Yeah, you could say take another piece and make a new cover for this journal and take this cover for another journal. Of course, that would be an opportunity, but the problem is this will become a personal journal that I want to use in 2022, the whole year of 2022. So when you see this video, it is 2022. So while I'm recording, it's still 2021. But that doesn't matter. It's a personal journal, and I want to use this fabric here on the inside because this comes from my grandmother. She had a chair covered with this fabric, and this is some leftover. And this memory is so big for me that I want to have this in my personal journal. So I have to find a way to solve this problem. And my plan is, and I'm really not sure if that is a good idea, but I have no other idea. My plan is to cut this here in half and then make the spine a little bit wider, because when I put this here where I have sewn, where I planned that this has to be lined up, when I put that here and I flipped it that here, I can see that this is not totally enough. I mean, it's not much what's missing there, but it's a little bit, so that this sewing here can't be in the same line as this thing here. And that's not good. The second thing that I want to try is to put something in between of the both pieces that I will get here when I cut this in half to make that wider so that these ends become a little bit longer as well. And in the end, I think I will still have the problem that this whole thing is not a real rectangle. So I have to put something here to make it a little bit more grungy or something like that, that can peek out here to the sides so that it looks like I have planned it in that way. Since I'm making my videos in English and in German, I have decided, and because of the fact that I have to concentrate while I'm doing this, I think I can't talk while I do that. So I will give you some music in the following minutes and you can see me trying to manage this. And in the end, I will be back on and show you the end result and perhaps talk a little bit about my experiences and that stuff. So you will see the process with music. I hope that's okay for you. I also need a video in German, of course, so I don't have this twice, so I have to find a solution. I hope that's okay for you, and I'm really hoping that this will come to a good end. Oh my goodness. Thank you. I can hardly believe it, but here I'm back with my finished journal. I can't tell you how proud I am that this has a spine now that fits to the rest, that it has two cover pieces on the front and the back that are fitting, and I'm so proud of myself, I can't tell you. So let me tell you something about my experiences with this thing. So I really like to make soft covers, and I really enjoy that this is so, yeah, you know, so flexible and like a pillowcase or something like that. If you touch this journal, it's really, really cool. And I'm so happy that I have decided to make this long and really slim size. As I said in the beginning, this reminds me to a really oversized traveler's notebook, and the feeling inside is also like a giant traveler's notebook. I really, really enjoy this size, and I'm really happy that I took the time to figure out how to enlarge this cover, because now, as you can see, oh, excuse me, please, those front and back pieces go a little bit over the pages. I mean, yeah, I can't show that to you in the camera so well, but as you can see, this is really, yeah, way bigger than before. And perhaps you can see that better when I do it like this. I really enjoy this space here, because I'm planning to attach some kind of page tabs to the pages here and there. And I want to do that perhaps with some buttons. And I think it would look really strange if the cover is too small and all of those page tab thingies peek out too much. And especially if you want to take this journal with you in a bag or something like that, I like it when you close it and this is the end of the journal. I mean, the cover piece is the end of the journal. I don't like that when too many things are peeking out that can be destroyed when you take your journal away. So I'm really happy that I did that. And here in the in the inside, you can see when I do it like this, it's a little bit hard to open that, but I think this, yeah, since this was some kind of an experiment, I think that with the time this gets a little bit more flexible. When I open and close this, then I think this thing will become more flexible. This hard area here is because I have sewn along here after I have put some glue underneath, and that's the reason why this goes like this. I mean, that's of course a normal thing here. The layers are way thicker and way more sturdy than this flexible upholstery thing is. And yeah, I can live with that. This is a journal for myself, and I think I will enjoy experiencing how this will change, so that I can decide if I want to do this method in the future as well. And I think that's also a great thing about junk journaling. If you make journals for yourself, you can always try different things out and try if that works for you. These little scraps here, originally I thought I don't like them so much, because this straight look here and here, first of all, I was not so happy with it. But the longer I looked at it and the more I edit here, the more happy I was with this. And I think this is also a thing that makes this front and back piece a little bit more like this journal cover feeling. I mean, it's like this, like a blanket or something like that. And here, this thing gives it a little bit more sturdiness, so that this, yeah, I can flip it way more easy and way more, yeah, that it feels like a journal cover than without these little strips here. For the spine, I think the next time I would like to do it a little bit different. But here I had the problem. I wanted to use this fabric and I only had, yeah, such kind of fabric in this look, so that I decided that I want to put that here. I think the next time I will try to put something totally different here. Now, this and this is some kind of matchy matchy. I mean, the pattern is some kind of matchy matchy. So that's also the reason why I've put some darker colors here, to make the spine a little bit more popping up. I mean, I like when the spine is a little bit different than the cover. So I could only manage that by putting some darker colors here, but I think that's okay for me. Yeah, so you will see this journal during 2022, I think very often, because I have a special plan with this journal. I will tell you that in my next video, why I have made this journal and what's going on in this journal. So I hope you will follow me along with this adventure here of this special journal. Perhaps you could take some information or some details for yourself and for your own journals. I'm hoping that. And I'm really hoping that such a thing like this that happened to me will not happen to you. Okay, so thank you very much for watching. That's it for today from me. Stay creative, stay healthy. See you the next time. Bye bye.